It is universal. So how to tackle this neural climate change or neural warming whenever we are exposed to classroom and other things, and the same joy that we are experiencing whenever you jump out of the classroom should be there whenever you are getting inside. So this is very common. So how to get this intellectual sturdity and this mind power by which we can bring everything to concentrative attention? How to bring them into concentrative attention? So that is one question asked by everybody. Recently somebody asked me, you are telling that my mind is weak and you are willing me to advising me to make my mind strong. Already I am weak, so how a weaker person can be strong enough to make his mind strong? So you are telling that I am weak, how I can make myself strong? The shastras, they give answer for that. It is known as, see, a person is very weak physically, the whole body is weak, he cannot just move, but he is taking that energy drink. Because the adoption canal, what is the adoption canal there? That the drug is given through oral delivery. It may be intravenous delivery, it may be a hole insertion or a semi-invasive fixation, neuroprosthetic, whatever it may be. The person is having an adoption canal. What is it? Adoption canal. Even though the person's whole body is weak, if an energy drink is given to the adoption canal, immediately that supplies that energy to all parts, immediately the person is okay. Likewise, even though if you are weak, there is an adoption canal which may not be weak for most of the people. So the adoption canal which is going to receive that strength dosage is ready for all of the people, provided that is given in a palatable, appreciable, admirable and jubilant methodology. That we have to invent a new methodology in which we can very jovially, see, if it is too jovial, then it will become a fun and we don't have any essential absorption at all. If it is full of stuff and essence, it will be a punishment in disguise. So we have to create some sort of a semi-serious voyage in which we learn everything, but learn things with simple and sweetness. So this adoption canal is where we are having some sort of hope or possibility, where we can believe that we can become strong in spite of becoming weak or being weak. Because of adoption canal, that is, what is our adoption canal? It is our urge, it is our desire, it is our will. That adoption canal, if it is properly used, we can get lot of these benefits. I will tell you few exercises. There are four major exercises. One is calmness. It is very much told in the shastras and it is very much perceived in the society also, to be calm. To be calm out of irresponsibility, out of sluggardishness and out of lack of interest or some other non-commitment, that is entirely different from this type of calmness. This type of calmness is not a recreative, it is neither a sluggardish nor irresponsible in nature, it is an active calmness in which you take a step of tranquility by which you are getting lot of things which is inside you to organize your own self in a very fantastic manner, which you cannot do even by hundreds of exercises outside. So four exercises. One is calmness or tranquility exercise. Second thing is visualization or internal stimulation exercise. That is also very much essential. Third thing is cognitive drilling exercise. Fourth is the vision. So there are 10 or 15 exercises for becoming calm. To become calm means you should not have any binding factor like appetite, like thirst, like various other biological instincts, like irritation, some other commitment. See, somebody is asking you to do something in the office, so you must not observe calmness, saying Swami has told me to become calm. So without any commitment, without any internal demand or external demand, you must be in a convenient position to sit and decide about this calmness. So every time, the calmness is of three types. One is thinking about something that is calm in nature, like nature, that I feel that I will be more tranquil and complacent if I there in, say, a forest or inside a valley or in a plateau or in the backwaters or anywhere else except my home and office or school. That is one model. It is searching an environment. And second thing is, wherever you are, you can just sit quiet for half an hour. Whenever you are going to write an exam, whenever you are going to read something, after being exposed to reading, writing or analysis, getting yourself calm will naturally, see, you need not organize anything at all. Naturally, the mind can organize itself. All these stuffs can be organized itself. All data can be organized by its own nature. That is incidental data, chronological data, biological data, observative data, experiential data. Everything can be arranged and organized by its own self. But you must allow some time for that. So sitting in, say, calmness is a good exercise daily, at least. It is the first step. In calmness also, there are innumerable calmness exercises. You cannot directly go for the 10th exercise as you are not exposed with natural calmness. Natural calmness within your desired ability is not administered by you. So going for advanced techniques is very impossible for you. So the third type of calmness, the first type is searching an environment. Second thing is suiting or tailoring one's own environment. The third thing is to create an internal drive by means of mantra or yantra, pujana, bhajana, bhojana, whatever various things are there. So taking something which you consider to be a driver, either you can practice or somebody can induce as an inspiration model, you can get all of these things and you can make this thing possible also. So this is also a type of driver to get that calmness. If you are having that calmness, now the next, if we are going to discuss, it should be about the calmness exercise alone. But that should require a marker and I have to write that, because that will be full of exercises. That is not in the form of narration. That should be in the form of exercises, how to develop calmness. Anybody developing the calmness, number one, they will be able to get visualization. For example, if they see about, for example, any person, really it happened. That's what I told in Serendipity. Most of the scientists, their interventions or inventions are very limited. They have been driven by their intuitive will. Due to their overlonged or prolonged desire and commitment towards identifying the product or identifying nature of the element, they have been totally lost in the space. That is lost in space. They have been totally lost in space, complete detachment, total focusing on the same thing. What is this? What is this? Without knowing. There are two things, without any input and with inputs. Without any inputs, lot of people, without any devices they have invented. Now we are having devices, already existing inputs in the form of networks and as well as research publications and various things. The problem is at that time, as they were not having all of these things, their handicapped nature, the lack of proper inputs, lack of proper devices, as they are handicapped, that has created an additional zeal. That has created an additional zeal by which they succeeded. The natural available demanded zeal itself is diluted now, so we are not able to function. With the 2x, the zeal got that zeal multiplied into 10x and they performed. And 10x, even if it is given supplied to the modern people, they will dilute it to 0x or minus 1x. That is the situation. In spite of having, we are struggling in spite of having lot of inputs. We are having the dynasty of various inventors. We are having the total continuity of various sex and dimensional views of the various things by various universities we are having. Still we are struggling. Everything now we are having microscope, we are having computer for processing, storing, identifying, modeling, everything we are having diseases. They did not have because they had the internal courage. They had the internal source. The internal source is very much important. So somebody asked me a question. Already we are struggling with the books. If you are going to teach something else, will it be really something complementary? Or will it be a load, additional load and burden to our already existing thing? Somebody asked this question. You are teaching something which we don't know. From our elementary class, we have been studying about science, biology, at least the names we have heard, and we have